Good afternoon. Now we are going to be with exercise number 2, that is on unit number 4. And in this exercise, actually, we have problems that is for torsion only. So we have these three problems which are from Gere and Temu Shanku. So now we will go one by one these problems. So we have given first problem, a hollow aluminium tube used in a roof truss has an outside diameter 100 and inside diameter 80. So we have given this as a hollow tube, and external and internal we have given values. So this is given, we have as 80, and then outside we have given this as 100 millimeters. Then the tube is L is given 2.5 meter and aluminium shear modulus is 28 MPa. So these data are mentioned over here. If the tube is twisted in pure torsion by torques acting at the end, so what is the angle of twist? We have to find angle of twist. So now J, that is polar modulus we have, that is for hollow tube, is pi by 32 d4 minus d4. And we have substituted this value, gives me 5.8 into 10 to 6 millimeter to the power 4. So first we have angle of twist, A part T by J is equal to tau by R. And from this, if we will put the value, we have T is equal to tau, that maximum shear stress that is given 50. So 50 into T, J we have calculated 5.8 into 10 to 6. Upon R, radius is 50. So we will get T as 5.8 into 10 to 6 Newton per mm square. Now using formula T by J is equal to G theta by L, because we have torsional formula, T by J is equal to tau by R is equal to G theta by L. In first part, we have taken first and second term, and in second part, we are taking first and third term. And from this, we will get T we know, L we know, G we know, J we know. By substituting this, we will get this value in radians, but we have to find in degrees. So we will multiply it by 180 by pi, so 0.0893 into 180 by pi will give value in degrees, 5.12 degrees. Then in second, we have to find out diameter of solid shaft. You can see this. What diameter D required for a solid shaft to resist the same torque with the same maximum shear stress? And then now we know torque. So we have formula for solid shaft, T is equal to pi by 16 D cube into tau max. And now we will have value of T, we will have value of tau max. And we have to calculate value of D, which we will have 83.91 millimeters. So we have to provide minimum 84 millimeters. Then if we will go to the third part, we have what is the ratio of the weight of hollow tube to the weight of solid shaft. Now we have seen, we have formula for weight of hollow shaft to solid shaft, that is D square minus D square of hollow upon D square of solid. We have modified it. If you will go through the lecture of torsion from the video, then you will come to know we are going to get value in this way. So we have actually weight, if we will see weight, we have unit weight of material into volume, and unit weight we have gamma, into volume we have area pi by d square minus d square into length. And these terms, this is for, if we will say this is for hollow, then for solid we have gamma, we have same pi by 4 into d solid square, I can say, into L. And from this we have actually pi by 4 gamma gets cancelled, and we have remaining portion d square minus d square upon d square. And then we are going to substitute the values, that will give us value that is equal to 0.51. So we have this value 0.51. So this was the first problem from the exercise. Now second problem, we have given what data we have given. P is given 120 into 10 to 3 watt. So this millimeter is actually not there. Then N we have 1.75 hertz. And then tau max is 45 MPa. What is the minimum required outside diameter? Then is again very simple. So we have T average into 2 pi F. So because F is in hertz frequency. Then we will substitute the value of P, and from this we will calculate value of T average. We will get T average 10.91 into 10 raised to 3 Newton meter, because we know whenever we will get value of T from power, it is always in Newton meter. Then formula we have, that is T by J is equal to tau by R. If we will write third term, then we will have this as flexural formula. Now we are interested with these two terms only. So T is equal to pi by 32 D to the power 4 minus D to the power 4, because J we have pi by 32 D4 minus D4, and that is into tau upon D. Now you can see this, we have given the inside diameter is to be half of the outside. So we will have small d, this value of small d is 0.5 into capital D. So we will substitute 0.5 into capital D, and by substituting this, we are going to get value of d that is equal to 109.62 millimeters. So we have to provide a minimum 110 millimeters. Tau we have 45 and d we have cancelled from this. We have taken, if you will go one step again, pi d4 in bracket 1 minus 0.5 to the power 4 upon 32 d into tau. Then 1 d gets cancelled, it becomes d cube, and that we have taken pi by d cube 32 1 minus 0.5 to the power 4 into 45 and get value as 109.62 millimeter. Then we have third problem. So we have two parts in this one. So capital D is given 60, small d is given 40, and n is given 2500 rpm. So we have to go by 2 pi nt upon 60. Now power is given 150 kilowatts. What is the maximum shear stress in the shaft? First part we have this one. So we will go, given data we have this one. So then we will go with formula, that is P equal to 2 pi nt upon 60. And then we will substitute these values. P we have 150 into 10 raised to 3, n we have 2500, and T average we have to calculate from this. And we get 572.96 Newton meters. So knowing this value of T, we have again T by J is equal to tau by R, and then we are going to put a value again in the same way, because we have hollow shaft, and then we will substitute value of D. This value is 60, this value is 60, this value is 40. Tau, maximum shear stress we have to find, and this value again we have 30. T we have already calculated, then we can have this as 572.96 into 10 raised to 3 Newton millimeter, because we require value in Newton millimeter in this formula. And then from this, you can see this, and from this we will get value of tau, that is 16.83 MPa. Now we are interested second part, if the allowable shear stress is 30. So we have given allowable shear stress now, and we have to find power in this one. First power is given, we have to find shear stress. In second part, shear stress is given, we have to find value of power. So now P we have this formula, this is for hollow shaft, and we will find T from this, because everything is given in this one. And then from this we will get T as 1.02 into 10 raised to 3 Newton meter. So we have to calculate it first Newton millimeter, but convert it into Newton meter, because we know in power value of T is always in Newton meter. So this value is Newton meter. And from this we will get value of power, that will be 267.04 into 10 raised to 3. Actually this should be into 10 raised to 3, or I can say this as this we have 267.04, so I will correct it. So I have P is equal to 267.04 into 10 raised to 3 watt, or I can say 267.04 kilowatt. So likewise we have problems from exercise 2, that is unit number 4, and now we will stop here. So thank you.